brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ. One afternoon in 1953, a group of reporters and city officials were gathered at a Chicago railway station. The person they were waiting for was the winner of the Nobel Peace Prize for the year 1952. When the train arrived, a giant of a man, 6 feet 4 inches, with bushy hair and large mustache, stepped out of the train. Cameras flashed, city officials approached him with hands outstretched, and various people began telling him how excited and honored they were to meet him. The man politely thanked them and then, looking over their heads, asked if he could be excused for a moment. He quickly walked through the crowd until he reached the side of an elderly black lady who was struggling with two large suitcases. He picked up the bags with a smile and escorted the lady to the bus. After helping her board the bus, he returned to the crowd and apologized for keeping them waiting. The man was Dr. Albert Schweitzer, the famous missionary doctor who had spent all his life working with the poor in Africa. Moved by Dr. Schweitzer's act of kindness, one of the members in the crowd turned to the reporter standing next to him and said, "That's the first time I ever saw a sermon walking. That's the first time I ever saw a sermon walking." Yes, my dear friends, the best way to proclaim Christ is by our very lives. As St. Francis of Assisi beautifully said, "Preach at all times. If necessary, use words." Yes, preach at all times by our very lives. If necessary, use words. Today, the Church celebrates Mission Sunday, that Jesus commissions the 11 to go to the ends of the earth and to proclaim the good news. The Church, by its very nature, my dear friends, is missionary. And just like how Jesus commissioned the 11, he commissions you and me to go to the ends of the earth and to proclaim the good news, to be his witnesses. This mandate to be Jesus' witness is given to each one of us by virtue of our baptism. It is not just a mandate, my dear friends. It is our calling, our divine vocation to be witnesses of Christ, to be that walking sermon. The key to all our missionary work is love. Love should be at the very heart of all that we do. If there is no love, in vain do we serve the Lord. Love has been at the very heart of all that Jesus did and said. And that's why Jesus said, "A new commandment I give unto you, that you love one another as I have loved you." Jesus then becomes the point of reference, the yardstick, the measuring tape as to how you and I are called to love one another. And that's why Jesus says, "By this will all men know that you are my disciples, if you have love one for another." What does the Church mean when she says we are called to be missioners today? It means simply, my dear friends, to be the face of Jesus in this broken world. And how can we be the face of Jesus in this broken world? In the words of St. Francis of Assisi, you and I are called to be instruments of God, channels of God's grace and love in this broken world. Where there is despair, you and I are called to be God's channel of hope. Where there's doubt and confusion, you and I are called to be God's channel of true faith in Christ. Where there is darkness, you and I are called to be channels of God's shining light. Where there is pain, you and I are called to be God's channel of comfort. Where there is sorrow, you and I are called to be God's channel of joy. That's what Jesus did on the face of the earth. And that's what you and I are expected to do today. The theme for the ongoing Synod on Family that's happening in Rome right now is on the vocation and mission of the family in the church and in the contemporary world. Just like how the church by her very nature is missionary, every family, my dear friends, which is a church in miniature, Ecclesia Domestica, the domestic church, is also called to be missionary. Just like the church, every family is also a replication of the church, and every family is also called to be missionary. The ongoing Synod on Family emphasizes the urgency of proclaiming the gospel of the family in the work of evangelization. How can we proclaim the gospel of the family? It is when every family truly becomes what they are called to be. As St. John Paul II beautifully states in his apostolic exhortation, Familiaris Consortio, the document on the family in the modern world, he urges and he says to every families, become what you are. How can families become what they are? How can they proclaim the gospel of the family? When every couple, when every spouse in the family truly live their marital vows every day of their lives, when they joyfully proclaim the sacrament of marriage every day of their marriage life, they proclaim the joy of the family. They proclaim the gospel of the family. When every day the spouses work hard to be faithful to that vow that they made in good times and in bad, not just in good times, in sickness and in health, until death do us part. When you are faithful to that vow, when you're committed to that vow, you proclaim the gospel of the family. You manifest, by the way you live your married life, God's love for us and Christ's love for the church. When families are rooted and grounded on gospel values and virtues of humility, kindness, gentleness, tenderness, understanding, patience, forgiveness, and service, you proclaim the gospel of the family. When every time the spouses are reaching out to one another in love and forgiveness, parents to the children and children to the parents, such a family proclaims the joy of the gospel. They proclaim the gospel of the family. You become a witnessing family in the neighborhood, and people around you will start talking about you. They will start saying, there's something special about this family. You witness to them. You evangelize them by the way you live your family life. You proclaim the gospel of the family. When your families become schools of prayer, where there is daily family prayer and reading of the Word of God, and as often as you can, frequent the sacrament of the Eucharist and nourished by the body and blood of Jesus Christ and the sacrament of reconciliation, you proclaim the gospel of the family. Where there is daily prayer in your homes and families, where there is daily meditation and reflection on the Word of God, where there is often as you can, frequent the Blessed Sacrament, your families proclaims the gospel of the family. Your homes become sanctuaries where God truly lives and reigns. When your families, my dear friends, makes it a point to bring up your children in faith and moral values, your families proclaim the gospel of the family. When you insist on faith and catechesis in your homes, when you make it a point that as parents, you're not just physical life givers, but you're also spiritual life givers. You make God real for your children. And when you embody the gospel by the way you live your lives, you evangelize your children and in turn are evangelized by them. When you make it a point to bring up your children in faith and with the right values, you proclaim the gospel of the family. And it happens when faith is proclaimed. And parents, you have to proclaim that faith in your homes and families. When you do that, you proclaim the gospel of the family. Dear friends, there is a growing crisis of faith in the world that has led to a crisis in marriage and family. No wonder we have so many broken homes, broken families, broken marriages, single parents, divorce. Pray during this Eucharistic celebration that every family, the domestic church, may truly become what they are called to be, centers of faith and love, transmitting faith and love to their children, and thus evangelize and be evangelized by the members of the family, but being that walking sermon, that gospel of love and joy to one another in the neighborhood, in the church, and in the society at large. Amen.